In our previous section, we have worked on deleting individual products. But when we deleted all the products, then also this bottom section was displayed. So now we are going to work on this. I will remove all the products, remove, and also remove. You can see this bottom section is still displayed. When I click on this delete all, it is not going to work because for this button, we have not written any query. What I will do, I will come here inside this cart below this table where our table tag is closing. Below that, I am going to write PHP query, PHP code. I will open PHP. I will close PHP. Inside this PHP, I am just going to check for the condition. If my grand total, if it is greater than 0, only then I have to display the bottom section. I will copy this entire div, cut from here, and inside this echo, I am just going to paste that one. Echo, double quotes, paste, and wherever I am having double quotes, I am just changing it to single quotes. For faster, I will just create one file. File. Inside this, I am going to paste. Control F. I will search double quotes. I will just replace with single quotes. Replace all. All are replaced. Control A, Control C. I will close this file. Now inside this, I am just going to paste that one. Simple process. Wherever I am having double quotes, I have just changed to single quotes. And here I should be changing to shopproducts.php. Whenever I click on this continue shopping, I should be redirected to shopproducts.php. So this is our first page, continue shopping. If my grand total is 0, only then I have to display all these things. And here we are already inside PHP. Again, I do not have to write this PHP code here. I will remove this dollar. Instead, I am just going to paste the dollar here. And also, I will be removing this closing PHP. Save this. I will come. Now, if I refresh this, you can see that bottom section has gone because my grand total is 0 now. We have initially assigned the value as 0. If my products are there, only then I will be increasing the grand total value. As of now, I do not have any products, so grand total is 0. So it is not greater than 0, it is equal to 0. So that is the reason this part will not be displayed. Then I am just writing this delete button. I will come. And I will copy this comment. And here I am just going to paste. Now we have this anchor tag. For this also, whenever we click on this, all the products should be deleted. And this closing if, I will cut from here and I am just going to replace it here. So now what I have to do, I have to again start my PHP. I will write here PHP. And below this, I am going to close PHP. Here I will be writing else part. And inside else, I want to display nothing. So I will just write here echo. So inside if, this entire bottom section is displayed. Here I have written separately because we are going to write some JavaScript as well. And after that, we are just closing this if and we are writing the else part. I will come. If I refresh, that delete button will also vanish. Now my cart item is 0. Again, I will come to shop it. Add to cart. Click on this cart. 2 products are added. I will delete this. Are you sure you want to delete the item? Okay. Product will be deleted. Again, when I click on this, this product will be deleted. Only cart is empty. That message will be displayed. That bottom section, including this delete all button, will be vanished. Now, what I want to do, I want to work on deleting all the products. So, this is my demo project. As soon as I click on this, all the products should be deleted. Not individual products. Suppose I am having 10 products. all 10 products will be deleted as soon as I click on delete all button. So next session, we are going to work on deleting all the products.